Good morning. If you guys missed my last vlog, which was my 24th birthday weekend and kind of just like a catch-up vlog for the past month before that, because I know I didn't post for a while, I'm gonna have that link so you can check it out. I had a lot of fun editing it and you guys really enjoyed the style of that video. Consult that if you want to. Today, it is currently Thursday. What's happened in the past week? Not much has been going on here. The only super cool things we've done recently were have a Super Bowl party next door for our friend Haley's birthday, who lives there with Shelby. There really just hasn't been much going on.
I love this!
Today's gonna be a big filming day, so I thought that I would bring you guys along on that. We've got some really, really exciting surprise things happening very soon. But yeah, gonna film in a little bit. I got up and got ready. I am sick. I feel like the last time I filmed, which was my 18 self-care ideas slash like self-care routine video that a lot of you guys asked for. If you didn't see that, that's up on my main channel. I also finally posted that easy one-person meals video. When I was filming that self-care video, my throat feels how it feels now. I like made a full recovery and now I'm back to like not feeling good. Right now my camera battery's charging before I film. So I'm gonna go make some breakfast. Hello.
That's so funny.
Hi, friends. Hello. Are you talking about the, Shelby texted me we have 28 pounds of chocolate being delivered to our home today.
Today?
Yeah.
Are they bringing a truck?
It's exciting stuff, is it not?
But yeah, it's just insane. Vlog about it.
A certain well-known celebrity is coming to our house on Tuesday.
Make me better. Adrian's supplying all the meds up in here.
Currently whipping up some little like breakfast soy chorizo scramble. If you haven't tried that from Trader Joe's, it's amazing. Breakfast life. This honking scramble. This looks like straight up meat. It's soy chorizo, then I scrambled an egg with it, but you can't see it because it just looks like the chorizo, tomatoes, red pepper, onion, mushroom, jalapeno, avocado, and green onion. Yum. What is Adrian over here working on?
I'm working on some work.
Oh. So my college roommate, Brooke, is having her bachelorette weekend in Miami in a couple weeks, so I ordered some cutie little stuff like this and these cups that say, okay, I quit, but they say Bride Tribe, and then one of them says Bride. So we're in there the weekend of the 23rd, I think. I've never been in a wedding before, so this is my first bachelorette weekend, and first all of that. All right, I'm gonna take a little hiatus from the vlog for a little bit, realistically probably a couple hours, because I'm about to film 3 videos to get ahead for when I'm in Miami, and just generally for like the next couple weeks to just like have all the footage, because if it's a sit-down video, then I feel like it just makes the most sense to go ahead and film all of it. That way I'm only having to set up like my audio stuff and everything once. I'm filming a favorites video because I haven't done one of those in a while. And it's more centered on like lifestyle favorites than it is like makeup. But there's a lot of like skincare and like there are products in it too. And I'm filming that assumptions about me video, or reacting to your assumptions about me that everyone has been doing lately, because I asked on Instagram to submit assumptions about me and a lot of you guys did. So I'm gonna react to those, I guess. And then lastly, the video that I've seen a lot of people doing that I really like, worst purchases in my 20s, like my worst purchases in my 20s, but I'm gonna combine it into like my 5 best and worst, to like 5 of each. Because I just thought that was such a creative idea and it was actually like good like life advice in a way. I think Monica Church started that. And I've seen Lindsay Hughes do it and Sarah Bell. So on my outfits to hopefully try to wake up, so that would be exciting and fun in these videos, because occasionally people comment on my videos asking me if I'm okay because they seem sad, and I'm just chill. I'm just a chill gal. Gotta film that.
Oh my gosh.
What if I eat them all before we need them for store?
Oh my god.
Are you kidding me?
Alright guys, a while has passed. I ended up only filming 2 videos because then all of my batteries and backup batteries had died. So I filmed my favorites video and then I filmed my assumptions video. I also just wanted to like prep a little bit more for my like best and worst purchases video. If you guys think I should do that together or separate it, let me know. I think I'm gonna stick with it together. But we're still ahead a good little amount. I got a really close parking spot to my house currently. I'm about to take advantage of that and carry all of these boxes from our little closet room down into my car so that I can take them hopefully tomorrow to donate them to Goodwill. A lot of you guys have asked about selling stuff on Poshmark or doing like an Instagram store store again. I really don't like the Poshmark. It takes kind of a hefty cut. I feel like it's like almost 20% or something. So it only ends up being like marginally profitable. I think I'm gonna do like a very quick sort through of the clothes I'm donating in case there are some like really good pieces that I think people might buy on Poshmark. But if I don't think there's gonna be much demand, or it's gonna be like a marginal profit or whatever, then I'm just gonna like go ahead and take it all to donate. That's that. We'll show you the situation. My arm's right there, and then we step out and we have this area, which is like overflow closet space because the closet in my room's kind of small. I did a closet tour if you wanna see all this in detail. But this is all stuff that has been in here for forever that needs to go to Goodwill. I have so many boxes. So I'm just sitting here on the couch editing one of today's videos. One's gonna go up on Saturday. I was just sitting here a second ago and I hear this loud like boom that literally sounds like something hit our house. So I like froze, and then like all of the walls, like the, well, I guess like doors mostly, but like it was like the front of the house and the back of the house all like shook, and I was like, did something just like crash into our house? So I immediately text Shelby because none of my roommates are home. And I was like, did you just feel all of like the building shake? And she was like, what? I'm not here. And since I heard that like boom first, it didn't occur to me that it could be an earthquake. Like if that hadn't happened, I would have thought it was an earthquake. But then I went on Twitter and everyone's like, whoa, did you feel that earthquake? And people were like reporting hearing this like boom. And it was, I looked at the time of all these tweets and then I looked at my text to Shelby and it was the same time. So like it was definitely an earthquake. I mean, it was very quick, but yeah, I guess it was an earthquake. But does anyone know why you like, is that normal to hear that? Like, I'm confused. Dinner, and watching 8 Ofs. Yeah, and just like miscellaneous. All right, Casey, you're up.
Oh, I don't have a wristband. Where?
Remchella. Happy birthday! Shelby, it feels to be 24.
It feels so, I feel so old.
Really?
No, not actually at all.
Brunching it for Shelby's birthday.
It feels
birthday.
Like a weird number, I'm like 24.
I think it's a wholesome number, 23 was like, 20 kept me on edge.
It is a weird number.
And
tonight I'm going to a Grammys after party, which I'm gonna tell you guys about in a little bit. My hair is so greasy. Now I'm going to shower and then I will be back in a sec. All right, so I kind of failed at that vlog the past couple days. I didn't feel good, so I just took a little, put it on pause. But today we're tying this in because as you can tell from the title at this point, I'm about to go to a Grammys after party. So this after party is actually hosted by Steven Tyler from Aerosmith, and it's for his charity called Janie's Fund, which supports abused women and girls. So it's just gonna be a fun little post-Grammys event. Me and my new roommate Mallory are going. I'm just really excited. I don't know what to expect. I don't know if it's gonna be like charity gala style in the sense of like it not being like that fun necessarily, or if it's gonna be like some poppin' after party. I really have no idea what to expect. All I know is the doors open at 9:30 and Aerosmith comes on around 10. So I'm so excited. This wasn't a cheap thing to go to, but it's going to a great cause. So, meet Mallory, the new roomie.
It's me.
You've seen her before. Attire was, what was it?
Glam, rock glam or something.
Oh, rock and roll chic.
Rock and roll chic.
So, we tried to look.
You can't see my gold boots, but I'm wearing them.
Oh yeah, she is cool. I don't know if the dark lip was a good call.
People,
is Tuesday morning at 9:30 a.m. We have like 10 friends over right now, and Chris Harrison's about to show up at our house.
Cute.
Chris Harrison comes in and spills champagne all over your new rug.
There's a lot of people here. This is a lot for early on a Tuesday. Mallory's not usually awake.
I'm so tired. I'm still sleeping.
I'm honestly shocked you're awake. This is impressive.
I'm shocked too.
Got lots of friends. Lots of chocolate. If you're wondering what this is, it's for this like truffle sponsorship, but I ain't getting paid, so I ain't gonna talk about it.
To run a show, kind of, he'll walk in, you guys are surprised. Mm-hmm. We'll have him standing-ish right around here. Which is interaction, just be normal. He's the nicest man, so.
Like, very much. I'm getting nervous.
This, I was, dude, when I was driving, I was like, why am I so nervous?
Yeah, I don't
know. Putting
a little
shaking, like what is wrong with me?
Oh,
just like, breakfast wasn't big enough.
Like, wait, my duck mother. Oh!
What do y'all do? What are y'all watching?
Watching the last time. Last year.
Love this show.
Yeah.
I just crashed the party.
Oh my gosh. Yeah.
So you're all neighbors.
Yeah.
You all randomly get together on Tuesday mornings and
yeah.
What a bunch of badass modern women. This is how you end up on The Bachelor. This is what happens.
Oh no.
Yeah, here, I think I have gifts.
This is
why
I like
fashion.
Is
it?
Red boots are
yes.
On point.
Thank you.
I'm squeezing in.
Yeah.
Usually get together on Fridays and watch the show.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Honestly, what do you think of the season? I think we've made up for Ari, who was never shirtless. This is a really good season.
Okay.
Yeah, this is a great season. And the next week goes back crazy.
Oh, yes.
We love that crazy.
The one where he jumps over.
That's
it.
I did try. Well, I did that at the moment. I would like to say I was thinking about my photographer, so I went and pushed the button. So he jumped the fence, and I was right behind him, and they were looking at me, and I was like, well, I just went and pushed the button, and the fence opened. But we were drinking later that night, and we were all debating, could we have done it?
So did you go back?
So we went back the next day.
Wow.
And we tried to recreate it.
Okay.
All of us.
How'd it go?
I will say I'm the only one that made it.
Yeah,
that was like legit.
Wow. He just went
100%. No,
that's totally CGI.
We were really trying to talk about
CGI.
CGI. Ironically, the same building they shot the moon landing. We did that. From now on, I told him much fatter, less athletic bachelors
than
I can. So I can keep up with them. But then we found him, and he's back.
He did run into some.
What he claims was a big beast, and I'm guessing it was like a poodle or
big
something.
Big beast.
Yeah. There's differing reports as to what scared him back into our arms.
Scared.
What can we do for you?
Awesome.
We have like a 10-camera shoot.
Yeah.
I'd love to do one grid shot standing where I line the girls up.
The camera's coming from this angle, so you get the side angle, so you get the good side leg.
Yeah, we're a full production.
Any guy who comes in here needs to be made aware of all the
cameras.
You are being videotaped when you enter these
rooms.
This is a YouTuber. Now it's a 3-camera shoot.
More than 3.
Oh my god.
Chris.
I love it.
He's like getting
it. I love it.
Are you boomerang light? That's my roommate! Thank you.
Could I tag you?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, all right.
Who's, whose house actually is this?
It's ours.
Okay, the three of you.
And then Janine used to live.
I used to live
here.
Oh, she was voted out.
Perfect.
If anyone reads it, it's a crime. You just, you can photoshop me.
You'll be voted out next. Who's up?
I mean, okay, fine.
We should get a shot of me shaving your legs.
Oh my god. Yes.
You want to go viral?
Get down.
Take a look at the hair, it's pretty bad.
This is very cute.
Guys, oh my god, it's Chris Harrison!
Thank you.
And pillows. I love it.
That was so well played.
We all
yeah. Wait.
Hold up your lids.
Yeah.
Love it.
Yay!
So yeah, this has been really something.
Chris Harrison was in this house.
He's so nice.
Yeah, he actually is. We were like, what if he was just like a complete jerk and he was totally not?
No, he's really nice. He's still here. He's been here for a while now.
Yeah.
He's been in our house. He goes to the bathroom, he's gonna use my toilet.
Chris Harrison's gonna pee in her toilet.
Lauren, I'm sorry. Take a moment. Say your goodbyes. Can't you say I made a mistake? Please just look me in my face. Tell me everything's okay. 'Cause I got it.